Looking to learn how to use the TradeStation web platform? Well, don't worry, I got you. In this video, I'm gonna walk you through how to set it up and how I use my charts as a power options trader. I'm gonna walk you through the settings, the layout, everything to make you feel comfortable using the TradeStation web platform. Let's get into it. All right, so let's cover some basics. First, you wanna go to TradeStation.com, and assuming you already have an account, you're gonna log into Web Trading Live. So go ahead and click that. This may open up in another tab like it did for me. And you're just gonna put in your username and password. Now, pretty simple, but once we get logged in, we'll be able to look at the platform. Now that we have the platform up, let me walk you through how I set mine up as an options trader. All right, so across the top, you're gonna have some tabs. I have positions as my default tab, which means if I have any positions open or current trades, it's gonna show right here. Next is the orders tab. So those are any positions that I have an order out for to get filled on, whether that's a stock or an option trade, and it hasn't been fulfilled yet or it hasn't met my price yet, that's gonna be open. The next one is gonna be your balance tab. So the balance is how much money I have in this particular account. So in this account, I have about $1,428. And you can see down here, it'll let you know like how much you have allocated to futures, if you're trading any futures, stocks, options, etc. The next tab is quotes. Now this is where you're gonna look at, I kinda like to call it a watch list. I wish we could rename it as a watch list, but we can't, but we'll just leave it as quotes. So any stock that you're watching. So right now I'm watching Run, I'm watching AMD because I have an actual AMD position in another trading account that I use. I'm watching EMPH, for example. But if you wanted to add another stock here, like Microsoft, you just click in this little gray area that says symbol. You type MSFT. That would be Microsoft, the ticker symbol. And voila, the ticker symbol is there. Now, similarly, you can add an option ticker symbol as well. So I'll type MSFT, but I wanted to add an option. I can scroll over here and click option. And then do I wanna do a call or puts? If I don't wanna show puts, I can just turn it off if I just wanna see calls. And if I wanna see calls and puts, I'll click that and turn it back on. And then I'll just scroll to the expiration date and the strike price and pick the option that I want. So for example, if I wanted a January 14th, 2022 expiration, $322.50 strike price call option, I'd click that. And boom, I'd have my stock symbol, Microsoft, then right underneath it, I would have my option symbol as well if I wanted to add an option to my watch list, all right? Now, you can hit this plus symbol, and these are a list of the things that you can add. So you can see you can add a chart. We already have our current matrix set up. We have a matrix here, and then this is a matrix. So a matrix is kind of like a collection area that you can add different tabs to. And I believe you're only allowed two matrix areas. So balances, we already went over that. Quotes, we went over that. Option chain, I'm gonna show you where I add option chain. I don't want it up here. Hot list is gonna show you a way that you can filter different stocks. And then you got your news, your orders, and your positions, what we already went through, all right? So these are the only tabs I like to have open in this horizontal position, all right? Now, if you go down here below, this is where I like to have my option chain and where I like to have my stock chart. And so this is a 5-minute chart, but if you want to change what the chart looks like, you can come over here and hit settings, and then you can change your chart settings. You can add studies to it. You can draw lines on it. So for example, what is a study? Let's just say I wanted to add MACD, all right, moving average, convergence, divergence. I click that, I hit okay, and voila. I now have a chart that has candlestick patterns on a 5-minute chart, and then I also have my MACD down there. And if I wanna enlarge this, I just go up here and hit these, this little, I don't know, expander button, and voila, I get this view right here. Now, if I wanna change the minutes, if I go all the way over here to the left, you can see I can click and go from a 5-minute to a 3-minute chart if I want. I can go from a 3-minute chart to a daily chart if I wanted to as well and say, what is the stock doing on the daily chart? And then again, you can also you know, use this to draw a line. So let's say you wanna draw some support. Let me see, Boom. So you have to hold your mouse down and then boom, I have a support, a resistance line, excuse me. And then I might want to draw some type of horizontal support line. So that's just how you use the drawing tools. That's also how you add a study to the bottom. Now I can shrink this back down and then I can hit settings. And if I want to remove the study, I'll just go studies and then I'll take MACD and I will hit the X and remove it. And then voila. Now, if you are on a chart that doesn't have candlesticks, you just click this little graph. It looks like a graph right here in the bottom left. And you can switch it from open, high, low, candles, and area, or you can switch it to a line chart, and then you can switch it back to a candlestick chart. Here you have your option chain. So that's another reason I don't necessarily like to add options up top, because I like to come down here, and let's just say I wanted to use Microsoft. I can pick the type of option I want. Is it a single? I don't want to look at all bullish, bearish, neutral, or volatile type strategy. So they're going to recommend strategies for you. If you don't understand how the strategies work, we break that down at Power Trades University, where we walk through that inside of our options trading course. But you want to take some type of trading or options training to understand what these strategies are. But a single just means I want to buy a single call or a single put option. And now you can see you'll have your implied volatility, your volume, open interest, theta, delta, bid, ask, strike, all of that stuff right there. And you can go, boom, what's the chart doing? And then you can say, here, we're looking at Microsoft. So we'll change this from run to Microsoft. Click on that. So we can say, boom, what's Microsoft doing on a daily? Do I want to trade options on it? And then over here, your hot list is if you want to do some type of basic scan. So I want to scan for equities, all indices, right? So the NASDAQ, the NYSE, the Archipelago, the Amex, and then what price, if I want to scan by price or volume. And then these are some of the pre-built in things. So I want to look for 1 day gainers, the gainers over the last 10 days, et cetera. And this will tell me who's kind of having a good day. So you can see MELI is up $108. So it's easy to pop back over here and say MELI. Let's see what's going on with them. Well, it's a $1,000 stock. So it's easy to see that it can move $100 in a day. And then you could pop right over here and go, let's look at the MELI option chain in case you want to trade some call options or some put options on it. So that's why I like to have my setup like this. Now, off to the side, again, this is a new matrix. And in this matrix, I can have all the same things I have over there, but why would I do that? So over here, I just like to have news. So now I can quickly pop in here and say, okay, I found MELI from the hot list. I looked at the chart and said, this is interesting. Looks like it's bouncing off support. If I'm not sure, I can draw a line and kind of say, all right, boom. That looks like a double tap of support right there. So I may want to take a bullish position thinking this can go higher, but then I may come over here and say, why is it moving today? And I might type in MELI and just say, you know, is there any news going on? And I might switch this to all category or all channels because it might not be anything under top news. So you switch it to all categories. And now you can see I'll have the latest news or at least what happened yesterday, according to them for MELI. I can click in here and read that. And I can kind of see what's going on, see what their price target is, volume, open interest. They give you a little bit of a options activity chart here. And again, if this is too small, just click that, pop it out like this. And now you can kind of read this, see what's going on with MELI, you know, see what they're talking about. And then boom, pop it right back in there and you're done. And you're done just like that. You got your complete chart setup. Now, if you don't like the setup being like this, maybe you want your news over here to the left. You can come in here and click this and switch your layout. So now it just switched the news over there to the left, but maybe I don't want news taking up that much of the screen. So I'll grab this bar and drag it over. And now you have a layout that is something like this with your news to the left. But I'm going to switch mine back because I like my news on the right side the way I had it. And I like to shrink it down just like that so that I have more of the chart in view, more of what's going on with the stock and all the different positions that I am watching. So I hope this has been helpful, helping you walk through how to use the TradeStation setup. If you want to learn how to paper trade with TradeStation, be sure to check out my next video. And if you haven't opened a TradeStation account, make sure you check out that video where we show you how to open a TradeStation account as well. And if you want some free training from Power Trades University and want to check out some of our free material to help you get started in the stock market, whether you're brand new or you're an experienced trader and you're looking for a new community and coach and training and stock ideas to be a part of, check out some of our links in the description. Thanks for watching. And remember, you never go broke taking a profit.